students. Now let us start with the first construction, right? In this we will try to construct the bisector of a given angle, right? As you can see in the diagram, we are given an angle ABC. We don't know the measure of angle ABC, right? Without even knowing the angle, we want to bisect it, right? What do we mean by bisect? Bisect means divide it into two equal parts, right? Bisecting means dividing it into two equal parts. So we want to divide this angle into two equal parts. So here are the steps of construction to draw a bisector of this angle. So let us start with the construction, right? The first step C is, taking B as center and any radius, draw an arc to intersect BA and BC at E and D respectively. So what I am going to do is, I am going to take B as the center, right? I am going to stick this pivot at point B, right? Now what I need to do is, I need to draw an arc of any radius, right? I need to draw an arc of any radius. So let me write it from here and let us draw an arc. Right, so we have drawn an arc of any radius, right? And the arc it is intersecting, the arc is intersecting BA and BC at points E and D respectively. That means that it is intersecting BA at E and BC at point D, right? So the first step it is done. Now what does the second step has to say? The second step says, taking D and E as the center, draw arcs to intersect each other F at F, right? So the next step that I'll be doing is, I'm going to take D and E as the center and draw other arcs, right? So taking my pivot at point E, right? Taking my pivot at point E, I'm going to fix this and I'm going to make an arc. Let me make an arc. Right, I have made this arc, right? Now what I need to do is, I need to follow the same procedure by keeping the pivot on point D, right? So I have kept the pivot on point D, and without disturbing the arc or the length of arc, I am going to make another arc which will intersect the previous arc, right? So I have completed step number 2 as well. In the step number 2, let me revise it again. Take D and E as center and draw arcs to intersect each other at F, right? So the arcs they are intersecting at point F. What you have done is, first you draw an arc taking B as center, right? Then taking E and D as center, keeping the arc radius same, you draw two arcs from E and from D, and the arcs they intersected each other at F. Now the last step, right? Second step is done. Draw ray BF, right? So what we need to do is, we need to draw the ray BF. We need to join B and F, right? So let us join B and F. We have B here, we have C here, right? So that will be, now this is our ray BF, right? So this is nothing but the angle bisector of angle ABC. We can see that BF is the required angle bisector of angle ABC, right? Now till now, in whatever construction that we have done till this class, we just did the construction. But in this class, we'll also try to prove why the construction, it gives us the required result. Let us try to prove it. Now I can see, what I am going to do is, I need to prove that these two angles, this angle and this angle, they are equal to each other. That is, BF is acting as the angle bisector for this triangle. So I am going to make a construction. What I am going to do is, I am going to join E and F and D and F, right? I have joined E and F and I have joined D and F. This is my construction. So let me write it for you. Construction. D join EF and DF, right? So I have joined EF and DF, right? Now let us take a look in triangles BEF and BDF. So in triangles BEF and triangle BDF, I can see that BF is the common side for both the triangles. So I can write BF is equal to BF, which is nothing but the common side of both the triangles. Both the triangles, they are sharing the common side BF, right? Next, I can say that BE is equal to BD. Now, why is BE equal to BD, right? From the first step, you can see that taking B as the center, we draw an arc, right? So BE and BD, they will have the same radius because they belong to the same arc, right? So you can say radii of same arc, right? Next, you can say that taking E and D as center, you draw another arc which were of same radius. So you can say that EF will be equal to DF, right? Because they are also radii of same arc, right? So I can see that in the triangle we have three sides that are equal for both the triangles. So I can say that triangle BEF and triangle BDF, triangle BEF and triangle BDF, they are congruent to each other by SSS congruence condition. Now what do we mean by SSS congruence condition? SSS stands for side congruence condition, because three sides were equal for both the triangles, so they are congruent by SSS congruence condition, right? Now we know from chapter triangles that when two triangles, they are congruent to each other, all the line segments and the angles of one triangle, they are equal to the corresponding line segments and angles of the other triangle, right? So I can say that angle EBF is equal to angle DBF, right? I can say that angle EBF is equal to angle DBF, that is by CPCT. Now we know from triangles, what does CPCT mean? CPCT means corresponding parts of congruent triangles, right? So I can say that both the angles, they are equal to each other, and if you take a look at these two angles, they are nothing but EBF and DBF, that is the angles marked by red. So I can say that these two angles, they are equal to each other, or by drawing ray BF, we have bisected the angle ABD, or we have divided the angle into two equal parts. So this was the required construction, and we have done the proof as well, which says that BF has divided the angle ABC into two equal angles.